His master said to him in reply, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest, for I did not plant, and gather, for I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given and will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Pastor, right? So two people wondered, talking about one another. how will you question your excellency or your evidence, so on and so forth. So on my first day that I preached to them, I said, don't worry about that, I'm very young, so just call me Bishop Han. Bishop, don't use last name, okay? Bishop Han. And if you happen to call me Father, then you ought to say, by Hail Mary for the nation. And you know what, on the first Sunday, I received at least 100 Hail Mary. All right. And then the next Saturday that I hear confession, and the people came to me and said, bless me, Father, for both. Do I need to say Father Hail Mary, Bishop? Sure, add it into your penance. You know, I come down there and with those Hail Mary, I become holier because they pray for me all the time. Now, the harmony. But today is a very special day for the Congolese, so I'd like to address to them directly. But before doing so, I'd like to say a few words of thanks. Very grateful to this community here, Blessed Sacrament, the staff, and all those who hold us for this evening's confirmation. Grateful as well to the Faith Formation Program Director, Gallagher, and all those who are volunteers to help prepare these young men and women for confirmation today. And for sponsors, I'd like to thank you in a very special way. You are here today, not only for ceremony, you are here today to express your commitment for the rest of your life to the young man and woman, all right? Okay, and your commitment to pray for them, your commitment to walk and journey with them, and your commitment to be an example to them for the rest of their lives, so that they can use the gift of the Holy Spirit to become true disciples like Jesus. So thank you very much for that. Parents and grandparents, I hope that this evening is a blessed evening for you, because this evening the church wanted to say thanks to you, because you have been noticing them, journeying with them, helping them in order to where they are right now. You know, your son or your friend, your daughter, your grandson and your granddaughter would not be here if you, parent, grandparent, would not be a source of encouragement and commitment to help us. And so, thank you very much. My sponsors, all right, you are committing to them. And I pray and continue to give good examples. And bring forward to my brother Deacon and my brother Brother Chris, who are present here in this celebration. Let us give them a nice round of applause to show our appreciation. Now the homily, addressing to Confirmandi. Dear Confirmandi, I look at you right now. You are all looking very good this evening. You look happy. You look excited for this day. Your pastor, Father Quinn, just tell me that you are well instructed. You are well informed. You have taken the 2 years confirmation program very seriously. You are doing the service project. You wrote letters to the bishop that you rehearsed, and now you're ready for this celebration. And so I'm happy to be here and pray for you and with you. Now, none of you is nervous, right? And that's wonderful. Which means that I can ask you any question I want. Right? Now in a moment, you will come up and I will anoint you with the sacred chrism on your forehead. With your formula, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit and your without payment, the confirmation statement is not valid. It's a without payment, which means that you are not living in the sacrament. Amen, that's what mean by you believe. And so make sure you say amen. Otherwise, I will wait. Wait until you say amen. The Holy Spirit gives me that patience. So make sure you say amen. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When you are saying amen, you are saying yes. Yes in three ways. Yes to belong to the Catholic Church. Yes to disciples of Jesus. Yes to Christian service. You know, some times ago in the past, that the holy water was poured over your head, and these words, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, were spoken. Do you remember that day? Maybe not. Because most likely, you don't have recollection of that day, but you were very, very, very young. But you know what, on that day of your baptism, you are incorporated into the Catholic Church community, the Catholic Church family. And so, confirmation is the completion of baptism. So at your confirmation, you are saying yes to belong to the Catholic Church. And the Catholic Church brings us to God. The Catholic Church connects us to Jesus Christ, our Savior. And as Catholic, Jesus Christ and the Catholic Church, He found our one. They are not inseparable. And we express that faith every time we celebrate Sunday Mass and when we say the Creed. Today, you don't say the Creed because you are going to renew the baptismal promise, which replaced the Creed, which replaced the profession of faith. What we say in the Creed, what do we say? I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. One, Jesus Christ and the Catholic Church are one. And when the Catholic get together, the Catholic Church does an incredible thing. Think about that. We educate lots of people through the Catholic school. We have a Catholic school here, right? By the way, wonderful Catholic school. And we have 40 Catholic schools in the Diocese of Orange. We feed the poor. We feed the hungry. We reach out to the immigrant, to the lonely, to the people depressed through the framework of Catholic charity. And we heal the sick through the hospital ministry. Here in our diocese, we have St. Joseph's Hospital and the Catholic Church help out the young children, like we have the confirmation program in our parish. But that is only the local level. The Catholic Church is universal, international. And so you can multiply that into many, many, many dioceses around the globe. And so you can imagine how many Catholic schools, Catholic universities that we have in our Catholic Church, how many Catholic hospitals, how many Catholic charities, and Catholic relief services doing wonderful jobs. Even though right now, they are working hard to reach out to the refugees, to the suffering people in Ukraine. You heard about the war. And Pope Francis just recently spent 1 million euros to free a nun kidnapped by Al-Qaeda-linked militants. I can go on and on talking about wonderful things that the Catholic Church has done. But you get the picture. Right? And those are the few things that I am proud to be Catholic. And the Catholic Church help you in your spiritual life. Right here in the Blessed Sacrament Parish, you see that every Sunday, every day, you have Mass. that the Catholic Church keep your soul and keep your body, keep your soul with the Word of God and the sacrament, and also help you to be reconciled with God and with one another, to have peace within your heart in the sacrament of reconciliation. So, of course, yes, you remember that, right? Yes, to belong to the Catholic Church. Now, that belonging to the Catholic Church entails the call that you and I are called to have. And what is that call? To follow Jesus Christ. And Christian and Catholic, we are Jesus' followers. And so the second yes is the yes to disciples of Jesus Christ. What does it mean to be the disciples of Jesus Christ? Primarily, is to have personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Just take a look at the life of the disciples of Jesus. Peter, James, John, Andrew, Bartholomew, Matthew, and all those 12 people, 12 apostles, they have spent 3 years with Jesus Christ. They witnessed Jesus' miracle. They listened to his preaching. They ate with him. They drank with him. They prayed with him. That's why they had personal relationship with him. And then finally, they witnessed Jesus' death and resurrection. And so they received the gift of the Holy Spirit to go out to witness to Jesus Christ with their personal relationship with him. And so you are the same. If you wanted to have a relationship with Jesus Christ, then you ought to know him. You ought to spend time with him. You need to pray with him. And so you are called to love one another as Jesus loved you. So that the people out there look at you, how much you love one another, and you know what, they recognize you? They recognize you as the disciple of Jesus. So that second yes is yes to be true disciples of Jesus. So what are the disciples of Jesus called to do? To do what Jesus did. Basically, like that. To do what Jesus did. And what did Jesus do? You can go into the Holy Gospels and find out, but it comes to my mind, I share with you one image of Jesus Christ. One image of Jesus Christ at the Last Supper. What happened at the Last Supper? Jesus knelt down and washed the feet of the disciples. According to the Jewish tradition, washing feet is the task of the servant. And so after washing done, Jesus taught the disciples and taught all of us the mandate, the commandment. I am your master, your teacher, and wash your feet, so you must wash one another's feet. Then, the third yes. Yes to Christian service. Well, like I said, that you have done service project, right? Don't stop at confirmation. All right? Because confirmation is not graduation. You think that, okay, well, I graduated, so no more Christian service, no more going to the church format, no going to the learn about the scripture. No, confirmation is not the graduation. Confirmation is not the end of your learning. Confirmation is just the beginning. The beginning of your discipleship. The beginning of Christian service. And so, I would encourage you to continue to do that. And next time you do the service, bring someone with you. Bring someone who isn't in the Catholic faith anymore, is not in the Christianity at all. Bring them along with you and show them that we are called to serve. We are called to follow Jesus as Jesus did. And tell them that how wonderful to be the Catholic. Right? And then you can bring Father's will, Father's courage, Father's helpless, and so the thing asks me to want to do for me in the meeting. So, yes, we should say. 3, 4, yes. Do you remember? If I give the quiz, do you remember that? Yes, you belong to the Catholic Church. Yes, to disciples of Jesus. And yes, to Christian Church. Now, I have received your letter 103. I think it's 105. Something like that. I read them all. 105. I read them all. About 3 hours or so, and I read them all, and I have to select 2 that I believe that capture the spirit that you wrote, because I don't think that this community or others would want me to read them all to them. I don't think so. Alright. And so here the first thing. At the start of my confirmation journey, I didn't really know what the point of getting confirmed was. But toward the middle of my second year, I started to realize why I was doing this in the first place. To better myself as a person and to grow closer with God and my faith. I was raised in the church ever since I was born. I was baptized at 1 month old. Growing up, I never really looked forward to faith formation classes. I always thought it was a waste of my weekend. Now, nearing the end of my faith formation experience, I was finally able to recognize how influential learning about my faith is. At one point, I even questioned if I believed in God. But now, after opening myself to the church, I have found a new spark that drives me to become a better person to myself and to others. I'm not sure if I have had that extreme moment of realization where Jesus has shown his presence in my life so clearly. But during the short phase where I questioned my faith, I fell into a kind of an impressive state due to complicated family issues. And I was lost and stuck. I didn't know what else to do, so I decided to turn back to my faith and started to open my heart to God, pray more, and become more active with the church. At first, I kind of used it as a distraction and an escape from reality. I'm not sure when the exact moment was when I realized I was slowly getting better and that depressed feeling was slowly turning into happiness. And all I knew is that I have happened in the word for God. Currently, I'm still working on getting better, even though that happened months ago. But I know whenever I feel like I'm spiraling downwards again, I can always come to God. And I know that He can guide me and help me. My experience with the Paris retreat is almost too difficult to put into words. I learn more about God's influence in other people, and how He helped them even know their love was kind. Through group sharing and reflection, I got to know more about what people experience in their lives and how I'm definitely not alone in what I have gone through. I felt safe and seen knowing that I am not the only person going through tough times and that I'm always surrounded by people who love me. There was a different kind of comfort and connection that I had developed with the people around me. I would like to be confirmed so that I can keep expanding my knowledge in the faith and so that I can stay active in the church, more knowing that I've been confirmed. Being confirmed to me would mean that I'm officially a member of the church, a child of God, and a servant of God. Thank you, Bishop, for taking the time to read my isn't that a wonderful letter? Let's give whoever wrote this one a round of applause. It's better than my homily. The second letter the same name I came to get involved with is Saint Teresa of Avila. I chose to be conformed with this same name because of her story and how I relate to her thought. Saint Teresa taught me that it is okay to struggle with your faith as long as you know that Jesus loves you and waits for you to come back. During COVID, it was a high and low for my faith. I didn't know where to go or who to turn to, and wondered why God would let this happen. The high part of this was being able to find the Bible and read the whole thing. And I finally figured out that no matter where you are, God is there. A powerful moment in my relationship with God was when I realized both my mom and dad were sick. My dad always had seizures, and my mom was at the time recently diagnosed with breast cancer. My family and I always went to Mass on Sunday, but that was a given during COVID. We began to go as much as we could, even if it was online. I was so stressed about if I was about to lose both of them. And then my mom and dad started helping at the church. He would take a month, my dad began to have less and less seizures. And right now they aren't happening often at all. Meanwhile, my mom was able to get surgery. And now the reports are coming back sick and saying that she is good. Of course, she has a monthly checkup, but she seems a lot better. I felt it was so powerful how God spoke right back to me, even though I am such a messed up person. As said in the beginning, I'm writing this letter to have your blessing to be confirmed. I want to be confirmed because I know that this will be a stepping stone in my faith. I realized that I had a choice, and as I sat on it, I realized that being Catholic was how I wanted to be known in life, and how I wanted to live my life. I wanted to know that I could be living by God's one along with Jesus and the Holy Spirit. Being confirmed would be the spark that lit the fire to a new beginning of our lives would be here. Bishop, I am asking for your blessing for the sacrament of confirmation this year. I thank you for watching over all of us, for God, and thank you for taking the time out of your very, very busy day to look over this letter. Isn't that another wonderful? Well, you need to keep on having those kinds of relationships that you wrote in your letter to Bishop, all right? Like I said, confirmation is not an end, it's not a graduation, but it is the beginning of your Christian life, your Christian service. Confirmation is about to happen. Well, the bishop is here, all right? The sacred oil is ready. All you need is to have your heart open. Open your mind and your heart to let the Holy Spirit come down into your soul, to grant you the gift of the Holy Spirit. And those gifts will help you to say yes to God fully, genuinely, and faithfully. Yes to belong to the Catholic Church. Yes to true disciples of Jesus. Yes, to Christian service. What could be better than that? What could be more powerful than that, than the life lived in and through our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior? At this time, I invite all those meek and firm, please stand. I'd like to have your loud and clear response. If it's not loud and clear, I will repeat the question. And you don't want that. Before you receive the Holy Spirit, call to mind the faith which you profess in baptism. And so, do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today through the sacrament of confirmation is given to you in a special way, just as it was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for thee, his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. I invite the priest, please stand and raise your hand over these candidates. Also, the sponsors, God help, please stand and raise your right hand over the shoulder of the candidate. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to you both by water and the Holy Spirit, free them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit of power, please. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Give them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Be still with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Be speaking. hear the same. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Joseph, the body of Jesus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Lord of Jesus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Moses the Black, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Luke the Apostle, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace.
John the Apostle, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Mary Magdalene, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Guardian of Jesus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Colette of Bobby, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Vincent de Paul, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Teresa de Avila, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Angela Marisi, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Mary, Mother of God, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Guardian of Jesus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Edward the Peace, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. John the Baptist, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Francis of Assisi, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Guardian of Jesus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Francis of Assisi, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Michael, the archangel, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Mary, Mother of God, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Matthew, the Evangelist, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Teresa, Father, love is sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. You would agree. He see you with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Martha of Bethany, he see you with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
Thank you.
성령 모두가 믿음을 드리는 어머니
Please rise, my dear brothers and sisters, let us honor
humbly pray to God the Almighty Father, and be of one mind in our prayer, to set faith, hope, and charity which proceed from His Holy Spirit. Amen.
For the Holy Church of God, together with Francis our Pope, Heaven Banner, Bishop, along with Bishops Timothy and Thomas, and all the bishops, and gathered by the Holy Spirit, the Church may grow and increase in unity of faith and love until the coming of the Lord. Let us pray for the Lord. For the peace of the world, that all people who have one Maker and Father may acknowledge one another as brothers and sisters without discrimination of race or nation, and with sincere hearts seek the kingdom of God, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray through the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Listen favorably to our prayer, and
when does your divine grace be first and foremost, when is the gospel will first proclaim? May now spread to the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Sanctify, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made here, and cleanse our hearts by the light of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Pray that we are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, as we become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
With the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. We need to confirm faith and charity, your all people, church, and earth, with your servant Francis, our Heaven, our bishop, Timothy and Thomas Titan, his one bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, the religious, and the entire people we have gained toward your own.
Whom you cast mother before you, to your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are listening to you, a dear passing from this life, give kind allegiance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May the outpouring of the Holy Spirit cleanse our hearts, O Lord, and make them fruitful by the inner sprinkling of the dew. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. First of all, as the pastor of this parish, I would like to thank our auxiliary bishop, Bishop Thomas Tighthand. And this is his third or fourth time coming to our parish. And we wish that next time he comes for some ceremony, he could go with us. That's fine. So give him a big applause for his love.
Father Carter, all priests, deacons, sisters, sponsors, parents, family, My first year of confirmation began at the same time as when I started attending a public high school after 9 years of Catholic education. At the time, I occasionally lost sight of God when our conflict leads to being questioned by my priest. In various situations, my classmates brought up controversial topics, and I wasn't sure how to respond to them properly, so I chose to remain silent. By the second year of confirmation, I learned how to defend our faith through several mental illnesses. The ones that stuck with me include typology, along with deductive and inductive reasoning. Now I am able to answer my peers' questions about Catholicism whenever the occasions arise. On that note, I pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to guide us as we follow in Jesus' footsteps. I will now leave you with a quote from Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you.
You are in my prayer as you want.
walk into your future, so that you are able to use the gift that you receive today to become true disciples and to serve the elders and to serve the church and find more people to give to you. And also pray for me so that I continue to do effectively my ministry here in the Diocese of Auburn. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Hold your head for a blessing.
May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom He has made His adopted sons and daughters. We mourn for God and the Holy Spirit, and may He keep you worthy of His fatherly love.
Amen.
May His only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in the church, bless you and confirm you by His following the confession of the true faith.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who kindled the fire of charity in the hearts of the disciples, bless you and keep you blameless, and gather as one into the joy of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying.